what do we do?
We fight the power.
They're bombing Africa by the hour. What do we do?
We fight the power.
Bombing Libya by the hour.
The former colonizers of Africa, the enslavers of Africa, are bombing Africa now in the name of protecting civilians. That lacks all credibility. The real reason is that Libya possesses the largest oil reserves in all of Africa, the ninth largest in the world. If the oil production continued today, as and every day as it does, there'd be enough oil in Libya for at least another 63 years. So that's a very big prize for ExxonMobil, Chevron, ConocoPhillips. This is another war for big oil to carry out regime change, to create, instead of an independent government, a government that's a client or a puppet of the United States. You don't have to be a 100% supporter of Gaddafi to realize that the NATO bombers are not doing this to help Libya. They didn't help Iraq. They didn't help Afghanistan. They're not helping the Palestinians. They have their own imperial interest, the interest of empire. So we're here today, very strong, spirited, militant demonstration saying that the American people, our time, are going into the streets to say, end this bombing.
Stop the bombing now!
Thank you.
Murphy, and I'm an activist with the ANSWER Coalition, which stands for Act Now to Stop War and Racism.
Why are you here today at this rally?
So I'm actually here today being a long-time activist. I realize that it's important that when basically the U.S. government is basically igniting these wars and saying that it's a need for them to supposedly protect all of these countries, and yet there's so many different injustices that happen here. Like, there's a lack of healthcare that's happening in this country. There's a lack of housing. There's a clearly a lack of jobs. And there was no money for that. It's pretty funny how a few years ago, there was money to give $7.5 trillion to the already rich. And yet, there's 9.5 million a day to get the dropping bombs on Libya. And they still continue to say that there's no money for us, for there to be any more jobs, any more housing. So it's important for actions like this to show that it's important to build the movement for change, for social justice and change, because that's the only way to make a difference, is to come out here, organize, make your voice heard, connect with people, and build the movement.
Thanks so much.
Sharon Black.
What group are you with, Sharon?
I'm with two groups today. Job is a Right campaign and also Workers' World Party.
And why is it important for you to be here at this rally in front of the White House?
Well, we think it's important for everybody to be here to oppose the war on Libya, which is a war on Africa, especially myself being from Baltimore, where people don't have jobs, where education is under attack. We feel that all the millions and millions of dollars being spent to bomb the people of Libya could be spent right here for jobs and education and health care. So basically our organization has been urging everybody to come to Washington, D.C. today, and then from there to be continuing to come out to stop the war on Africa.
Eugene, stretch it out!
September 11th, when people were afraid to stand up against the war in Afghanistan, people have been afraid to come out and stand against the U.S. NATO intervention in Libya and also U.S., UN, and Western interventions in Africa. But the reality of it is it's not about Gaddafi. They say it's about Gaddafi, the opposition over there, but the reality is they support an opposition that has former Gaddafi supporters, that has jihadists, that has CIA agents. So what it is the United States picking winners and losers out of an internal conflict in Libya. And just like they said in Iraq, it was going to be a great democratic revival, and it never happened. The forces they said that we would be a great democratic force never materialized. And here we are in Libya. It's the same lessons of Iraq. They've tried to make it about Gaddafi. It's not about Gaddafi. It's about whether UN and U.S. intervention and NATO intervention can bring freedom to the people of Libya. It cannot bring freedom to the people of Libya. It will install another group of exploiters to exploit the people of Libya. So we are opposed to U.S. NATO intervention in Libya for that point. Not just that it contravenes the right of self-determination, but because it in no way will bring any sort of humanitarian relief, peace, freedom, or democracy. And we also stand with the brothers and sisters here from Cote d'Ivoire about the sham election and the imposed government that France imposed on the people of Cote d'Ivoire. And we say all no to all U.S., NATO, Western interventions on the African continent, self-determination to the African nations.
Thanks so much.
Thank you.